Okay, the slope of Ohm's law graph, grade 12, physics. Depending on what you have on the x and y axis, you'll have a different slope or gradient. Okay, slope or gradient is the same thing. Okay, so you can have voltage on the y axis and current on the x axis, or you can have current on the y axis and voltage on the x axis. Okay, so depending on what you have on the x and y axis, you'll have a different slope. Okay, we are going to see that. So when you have the voltage on the y axis and current on the x axis, what is the slope? Okay, we use m for the slope. So the slope is equal to the rise over the run. Okay, the rise over the run. So the rise over the run. Okay, rise. Okay, rise, run. Okay, you rise and you run. Okay, so the rise is the change in the y axis. Okay, the rise is the change in the y axis over the run. The run is the change in the x axis. Okay, change in the x axis. So now the slope is equal to change in the y axis. You have voltage, okay, using this graph with what you have on the y axis and what you have on the x axis. On the y axis, you have voltage. Okay, so change in the y is the change in the voltage. Okay, change in the voltage over change in the x. Change in the x is the change in the current. Okay, change in the current. So this is equal to, now remember this formula. Okay, so to find V over I, okay, you have V, you need V over I. Okay, V over I over I. Okay, so this is V over I, you need V over I. So what you do on the left, you also do it on the right. Okay, you also divide over I on the right. So now, can you see, you are going to cancel I and I. Now you have V over I is equal to R. Okay, R, the resistance. Okay, so the slope of this line when you have voltage on the y axis and current on the x axis, the slope is equal to the resistance of the conductor. Okay, so let's move on. Now, when you have current on the y axis and voltage on the x axis, what is the slope? Okay, let's see. So the slope is always equal to the rise over the run. Okay, so the rise, okay, the rise over the run. Okay, so now the rise is the change in the y. Okay, the rise is the change in the y, and the run is the change in the x. Okay, change in the x is the run. Okay, you rise, you run. Okay, now the slope is equal to change in the y over the change in the x. So in the y you have current. Okay, so you are going to have change in the current over change in the x. In the x you have voltage. You are going to have change in the voltage. Okay, now I over V is equal to, you are going to use this formula, I over V. This is I. You need over V. Okay? Over V. Okay? Because you have I over V, you need I over V. So, what you do on the right, you also do it on the left. Okay? Now, can you see? You have V over V, which is 1. Okay? This is equal to I, the current, times the resistance. Okay, over V. Okay, so V over V is equal to 1. Okay, now you need I over V. You have I over V, but you have times R. So you have to get rid of R. You are going to multiply by 1 over R. Okay. What you do on the right, you also do it on the left. Okay, so you multiply by 1 over R so that you can cancel, so that you can get rid of R, because you only need I over V. Okay, so you are going to cancel. Now you have 1 over R times 1. So on the left, you have 1 over R. Okay, on the left, you have 1 over R equal to I over V. Okay, I over V. Okay, I over V. Now, can you see I over V is equal to 1 over R. Okay, I over V, I over V is equal to 1 over R. Okay, so the slope of this line when you have current on the y-axis and voltage on the x-axis, the slope is equal to 1 over R. Okay, you can also see, can you see that V over I is equal to R. Now, I over V, which is the inverse, okay? You're also going to get the inverse of this. Now, you're going to have 1 over R.